Let me introduce you to my new friend. Hey everybody, how we doing today? So, got my flippers on and the sun is going down, so it's another late run for a quick lobster. I actually have a new toy I want to play with, so I need a volunteer species, so a lobster's going to work. Another day burned waiting for the postman to show up, but never did, so I waited till 5 o'clock. I've got three orders for vertical jigs that I can't finish because I'm out of stock on a couple of the jigs. So Alejandro, Daniel, Dan, okay? Supposedly it's supposed to get delivered today, and then I guess I'll get your stuff out tomorrow. So thanks for being patient with me. But other than that, I'm gonna do a quick lobster run down here. Hopefully it'll work out, and then we get to play with my new toy. All right, we've got our lobster. I'm gonna actually check out one more spot. Water temps are dropped quite a bit, so it's a little bit cooler, but I think that's just these storms that are passing through are cooling down the winds, and especially at nighttime, it's a little bit cooler. But I did see quite a few less lobsters, but they're still in there. They seem to be dug in a little bit farther. But yeah, I think I'm gonna pick up one more for breakfast, and then we gotta head in because I still need to go to Home Depot to pick up some more supplies for the toy. So let me check this spot out. All right, got number two. That should do me for the day. Storms are starting to push through, so probably a good time to leave anyway, so let's get out of here. I ended up picking up the third one. I stopped at one more spot and there was a couple of nice jumbo ones there, this guy. So I went ahead and picked him up. So now I've got the three. Unfortunately, the Home Depot is closed. So I'll have to get my toys working tomorrow. So I'm gonna eat probably one for dinner tonight, one for the toy tomorrow, and then probably that one for breakfast. So, lost the lobsters. Well, the vertical jigs showed up, so we are all good there. Guys, I've got your vertical jigs all packaged up, ready to go out tomorrow, so at least that's done. Let me introduce you to my new friend. So let's get cooking. Okay, I've got that lobster all cleaned up and put on skewers. because you can never beat meat on a stick.
Don't you even think about touching it.
All right, let's test this guy out. Got our stick of meat. There we go. It's firmed up nicely, not translucent anymore, browned up a bit, but it could use a little bit more, but I'm gonna do something with it next, so next step. So now it's pretty much cooked through, so what I wanna do is give it a little bit more color. I'm gonna add a little teriyaki glaze, and I think that's gonna give, when I cook it again, it's gonna give it a little bit of a charred coloring. When that sugar start cooking, it'll create a little bit of blackness to it. Although it's already got the brown grilled part of it. So let's cook this up and be done. Sicked it. Alrighty, quick and easy. We got our meat on a stick all finished there. Nice, with a little bit of teriyaki glazed. Perfect. It's still moist on the inside, but cooked all the way through. And it's got a little bit of a cooked skin to it. Almost a crunchy texture to the outside. And the sweetness of the lobster, but extra sweetness because of the teriyaki sauce glaze. That is excellent. Perfect. So let me show you my new system. All right, that's my new toy that I'm gonna be using for a while here. It'll be nice and portable so I can do a bunch of stuff, even on the kayak, it looks like. But anyways, what this unit is, it's actually a two-piece unit. You got the head unit, and that's by a company called Searsol. Kind of hefty price. This runs around 75, 80 bucks. If you want one, get one from Amazon. Because if you go on eBay, they're way jacked up. They primarily sell just through Amazon. That's why it's a lower price. There was a big problem of these things being out of stock for like 6 months, and they were selling for like 300 bucks because the chefs really couldn't get them. But what they're made for is to do kind of not necessarily cook, but to do the browning part. So like when I do the sous vide steaks, you would use this to crisp up the outer edges to give it that dark and crispy part. Same thing with my pizzas. You can use that to finish things off, or like a creme brulee. That's kind of what it is, the professional style of doing that instead of just the regular torch there. And then it matches up with a Benzomatic TS-8000 series. It also works with a 4000 series, but it doesn't give you enough BTUs or whatever. But this kit cost me close $56 plus tax, around $60. So a bit pricey, but pretty cool. And I want to thank my Patreon supporters for that. I get to buy the cool toys because of you guys. That's where the money goes. But anyways, hope you guys found that pretty interesting. Like I said, it was just a test out of a new toy. So I think I'll be using this a lot more. Kind of my portable outdoors barbecue microwave, I think I'm going to call it. So anyways, thanks for watching, and I will see you next video. Bye.